2 and 3. Evangelii, Eli Tara,
Evangelii, 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 Evangelii. amen, amen, adu.
Balifela, bogukana.
Balifela, 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 bogukana. Amen.
We'd like to thank God this morning. It's time for our Sunday school.
Amen.
We invite the Holy Spirit to come and be in our midst.
Amen.
Because it said, where two or three are gathered in my name, I'll be in their midst.
Amen.
So, siyabonga noma sibakutshwana kakhulu ngenxa yesimo.
Yeah.
Siyathemba ukuthi uNkulunkulu unathi.
Amen.
Nabalalelayo basezindlini zabo.
Yeah.
UNkulunkulu uzobakusisa.
Amen.
It's time for the summary. Elementary. It's time for elementary summary. Which states Paul and Barnabas worked for Jesus. So Paul no Barnabas basebenzela uThixo.
UJesu.
Paul no Barnabas basebenzela uJesu. Acts 18 verse 1 to 52 and 14 verse 1 to 28. Memory verse is in Acts 13 verse 32. We declare unto you good tidings.
Amen.
We declare unto you good tidings. To declare good tidings to those who don't know the gospel is to preach the gospel about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So Paul and Barnabas were the first missionaries to preach the gospel to those who don't know Jesus. They started preaching to the Jews, and the Jews rejected the call. Then they tell them that because you rejected the call, you don't want to hear about Jesus, we are going to preach to the Gentiles.
Amen.
So that is why the gospel today reached us. It's because of missionaries. Do we know missionaries? Missionaries are people who are sent to a faraway country or a faraway place where people do not know about Jesus. Then when they reach there, they preach the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
They tell those people about the good tidings, the message of salvation, the message of redemption, the love of God and the love of Jesus. That is the work of the missionaries. That is what Paul and Barnabas were doing. Do we know Paul and Barnabas? Barnabas, his other name was Joseph. His name was Joseph. He was a Levite, and the apostles called him Barnabas.
Amen.
Meaning the son of encouragement. What a beautiful name. The son of encouragement.
Amen.
So it's about Paul and Barnabas. Then working for Paul and Barnabas working for Jesus. Now we know about Paul. Paul is the one who was called Saul. By the time he used to persecute the Christians, thinking he's working for God, but he was lost. We thank God one of the good days, God loved us all. One of the good days while he was on his journey to Damascus, going to persecute, to kill the apostles, to kill the Christians. Oh, the light of God shone unto him. He fell down and received Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He became a born-again Christian.
Amen.
Christian. Now, this Barnabas, he was Paul's mentor. He guided him in his early Christian life.
Amen.
The other apostles were afraid of him. But he's the one who did what? Who told the apostle that, never mind, don't be afraid of Paul. He's the of Saul. Because he was preaching the gospel in Damascus, fearlessly talking about Jesus.
Amen.
But they were afraid because they used to know that he would kill them.
Yeah.
But we thank God for Barnabas. With boldness and fearlessly without any fear.
Mm.
He told them about Saul, that he is a new convert.
Amen.
He is now working for Jesus.
Amen.
Now we see them in a missionary journey,
mm.
going to a faraway country.
Mm.
They have to pass the seashore to go to that place. Mm. It was the city of Antioch in Syria.
Amen.
Where most of the people did not know about Jesus.
Mm.
So, you know, I'm glad to hear about this teaching of the people who were bold.
Mm.
Ah, may God help us to be bold.
Amen.
May God help us to stand for the gospel without any fear,
mm.
like these two brethren, these two apostles.
Yeah.
You know what? They were called the first missionaries.
Yeah.
Do you know, we said that missionary spread the good tidings of Jesus Christ to the people who don't know the gospel. Now we see them going to Antioch to preach the gospel. You know what? By the time they do this first missionary, there were no planes, there were no buses,
mm.
there were no fast cars,
mm.
there were no highways,
mm.
there were no freeways like we had today.
Mm.
But it didn't hinder them to go and preach the gospel.
Amen.
They sailed with boats, and some of the boats sometimes capsized, but mm. God protected them.
Amen.
They didn't, it was a hard journey, but they never minded what they will eat, because God promised, I will supply all your needs. Even today, God is going to supply all our needs if we trust Him, in Him. Now we see Paul and Barnabas in a country where they don't know Jesus. They started preaching about Jesus.
Mm.
They went to the synagogue. It was on a Sabbath day.
Mm.
They did what? They preached about Jesus.
Yes.
The one they killed.
Mm.
The one they nailed on the cross. He told them that God loves them. He still loves them.
Mm.
Why? Because He died and rose again for them to be redeemed.
Mm.
But they did what? They were jealous. The Jews were jealous. They rejected them. But thank God, some of the Gentiles, they liked the gospel.
Mm.
And they told Paul and Barnabas to come and preach to them another Sabbath.
Mm.
Oh, we thank God. We thank God for the gospel. No one can stop the gospel from moving.
Mm.
Because here in this journey, you know what? There was a certain man called Elimas. He did what? He tried to hinder them. He tried to hinder them, to stop them from preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Mm.
You know what happened to him? He became blind.
Hey.
Oh, it's dangerous to hinder the gospel.
Yeah.
So may God help us not to hinder the gospel.
Mm.
Ah, we thank God. After that, there was a certain man in the Jewish, the ruler of the Jews, who wanted to hear Paul and Barnabas. Because they gave them chance to do what? To preach the gospel. But unfortunately, they didn't believe. They were jealous. So we thank God. You know what, little children? Our most important task in this gospel is to do what? Is to preach the gospel.
Amen.
Is to win souls for Jesus.
Yeah.
You don't have to be a priest, a pastor, in order to preach the gospel. No, you have to testify. The more we testify, we tell people about the love of Jesus, the more God will bless us.
Amen.
That is the great work that we must do, the great commission to tell people about Jesus. At school, at work, wherever we are, we can preach by testifying, we can preach by living a holy life.
Amen.
So we thank God. That's the summary, that's the end of our elementary lesson.
Mm.
Now let's come to our senior lesson.
Amen.
Junior and senior lesson.
Mm.
It's about Ananias and Sapphira.
Yes.
Oh, this lesson, it's a warning to us.
Yeah.
It's a warning to nowadays Christians. So ungathi uNkulunkulu angasisiza uma silalela lesifundo singabheki abanye abantu sizibheke. Let us examine ourselves that are we not like Ananias and Sapphira? May God help us. It's in our lesson, it's in Acts 4, it's in Acts 4, verse 32 to 37. Acts 4, verse 32 to 37, and Acts 5, verse 1 to 16. It's lesson 284, senior course, memory verse. It states that the getting of treasures by lying, by a lying tongue, it's a vanity tossed to and fro of them that seek death. Of them that seek what? Death. If you lie, it means you seek what? Death. We seek death by lying. God hates lying. God hates lying. Youth, don't we lie to our parents? Where were you? Ah, I was with my friends doing some homework. Whereas you know that you were busy partying, you were with your boyfriend. Where were you? Ah, there was a long queue at the shops. Can't you were doing drugs? The parents don't know, they even trust you. Oh, so may God help us.
Amen.
To lie. We lie to our teachers. We lie to our parents. We lie everywhere. God is watching. And there is a reward. May God help us.
Amen.
As youth. May God help us as elderly people. God hates lies. Are we not promising our children that we'll give them this and that and never do that? Are we not promising our wives, our husband, something and we don't do? We say, ah, it doesn't matter, she's my wife. It doesn't matter, he is my husband. It's lying. God has recorded that you promised to do that for her or for him. So may God help us. Ananias and Sapphira, let's look at Junior memory verse. A false witness shall not be unpunished, and he that speaketh lie shall not escape. He that speaketh lie shall not escape. You can tell a lie in order to get something. You can tell a lie in order to get a wife. You can tell a lie in order to get favor, from the pastors or from anybody. But you will not escape. It can take 5 years, it can take 10 years, it can take 20 years. But one of the good days, your lie will find you. So may God help us.
Amen.
Ah, this is a fearful lesson. May God help us all. Now, it's the junior memory verse. It's in Proverbs 19, verse 5. Now, let's come to our lesson. Let's hear about the early church, what they did. We know, we learned about the descent of the Holy Ghost during the day of Pentecost. And we saw miracles. We saw the lame man from birth walking. We saw the blind man healed. We saw the sick being healed. We saw many miracles done by the hands of the apostles.
Amen.
It was the manifestation of the presence of the Holy Spirit. So if there is no Holy Ghost, you won't see any power. You won't see any miracle. And we cannot preach the gospel. So this early church, oh, they loved God so much.
Amen.
They loved God more than anything in this world. They say they'd rather suffer, but get eternal life, but get treasures in heaven. That is what we. That is why we see them. There were so many. It is said the early church, the multitude of believers were of one heart and one soul. The multitude of believers were of one heart and one soul. Acts 4, let's read. Acts 4 from verse 32. Let's read from verse 32 to 37. They were of one heart.
Acts chapter 4, verse 32.
And
the multitude of them that believed were of one heart and of one soul. Neither said any of them that aught of the things which he possessed was his own.
Oh, we thank God we do not sit down just then. They said what? Neither of them said of the things that he possessed that it was his own or her own. Bekungekho umzalwane or umKrestu or umapostola othi lokwami. Asisibhekeni namuhla. Don't we say, this is my car? These are my children. No one can touch them. These are my things. Don't we see that? Are we united? Are we not like them? Are we not going to the same heaven as them? May God help us.
Amen.
Changa di chabo. Chabo di changa. During the early days, you know what? We used to leave our home and stay at the mission. There, if someone gets this jacket, first, she'll wear it. And I'll seek for something which is not mine. And I'll wear it. We'll meet at church. Wearing someone's clothes. It was very nice. And you won't say, you see her wearing like that, it's mine. Okay, you can continue.
And the multitude of them that believed were of one heart and of one soul. Neither said any of them that aught of the things which he possessed was his own. But they had all things common.
They had all things common. Do we have all things common? Or Okay.
Verse 33. And with great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And great grace was upon them all. Verse 33.
Okay. They witness about the resurrection of
Jesus.
People didn't believe, the Jews didn't believe, some of the Jews didn't believe about the resurrection of Christ, but it didn't stop them to preach about the resurrection of Jesus. They said we can be imprisoned as long as we preach the right gospel. Okay?
Verse 34. Neither was there any among them that lacked, for as many as were possessors of lands and houses sold them. And brought the prices of the things that were sold. 35. And laid them down at the apostles' feet. And distribution was made unto every man according as he had need. 36. And Joseph, who by the apostles was named Barnabas, which is being interpreted the son of consolation, a Levite and of the country of Cyprus. 37. Having land, sold it, and brought the money, and laid it at the apostles' feet.
Okay, it's 37. You know, there is peace in unity.
Amen.
The apostles heard Jesus praying for unity, praying for them, praying for oneness, praying for sanctification. You cannot have unity if you don't have sanctification. So may God help us.
Amen.
It is possible through the blood of Jesus. Igazi lika Jesu yinto lingasiyenza uma singathethelelwe izolo sanqwelisa. Igazi leli liyasiyenza ukuthi sibe one. I-sanctification isn't ayikukhuluma ngomlomo ukuthi I am born again, sanctified, and baptized with the Holy Ghost like it's a song. We need to live a sanctified life.
Amen.
A holy life.
Amen.
See, pila kanja, singayiphila nje ngokukhuluma ngomlomo. No, we must get genuine sanctification after being born again.
Amen.
So the rest will follow. So unkulunkulu makasize. Lava bebathethelelwe izono. bathole uJesu wabathandazela ukuthi batholeni ubungcwele lapho kuJohn 17. He even prayed for us because he said, I'm not praying for this only, but I'm also praying for them that will hear the gospel from them.
Amen.
And we heard the gospel from the missionaries. It reached us. He prayed for us. Do we have that sanctification? Do we have that oneness? Do we have that holiness? May God help us all if we don't have. Let us pray for genuine sanctification.
Amen.
But we cannot get it if we are not born again. So may God help us. So we come to that man. We heard about him during the elementary lesson, Barnabas. You know, Barnabas, he was a Levite. And we know that Levites were not allowed to possess anything, to have a land, to have anything. But he had a land in another country, not in that place where they stay. But even if it was in another land, he didn't hide it. He did what? He sold it and gave the whole money to the apostles. But, the love of man, there are some who did something, we'll hear about them. So, we thank God about Barnabas. Let's read 1 Peter 3, verse 8. Let's go back to unity. 1 Peter 3, verse 8.
1 Peter chapter 3.
And Philippians 1, verse 27.
1 Peter chapter 3, verse 8. Finally, be all of one mind.
Be all of one mind. If you can be of one mind, miracles will happen in our congregations. Okay?
Having compassion one of another, love as brethren, be pitiful, be cautious.
Be pitiful, be cautious. Singabi abantu abathanda ukuthi izinto zethu zisihambele kahle, abanye abazalwane zingabahambeli kahle. We must be pitiful, we must be cautious. We must have that love. Lokuthanda abazalwane. May God help us. Another scripture. Did you read Philippians 1 verse 27? And Philippians 2 verse 2. Can read in Zulu and English.
Only let your conversation be as it becometh of gospel of Christ, that whether I come and see you or else be absent, I may hear of your affairs, that ye steadfast in one spirit, with one mind, striving together for the faith of the gospel.
Amen. We encourage our abazala ukuthi noma ngikhona or angikho manyizwe udumo oluhle manyizwe ne unity hayi ukuthi uma umfundisa ngeke azwe i split or ukuhlukana kwabazalwane akuyike i split azolukisa amacala. What kind of the congregation is that? Let us resemble the early church.
Amen.
May God help us. So we also heard about when they sold their houses and their land. Let's read we have read Acts 4, verse 34, Acts 2, verse 45. Acts 2, verse 45.
Acts chapter 2, verse 45. And sold their possession and goods, and parted them to all men, as every man had need.
Yes, what went then? Well, after what they do, what they need, babuyisa kwabosola wabekiwa akunobunye kuthiwa lokhu kwabafundisi lokhu kwabadikoni lokhu kwalaba lokhu kwabafundisi abakhulu alaba icongregation ayitholi next. Such love.
Amen.
Such unity. Babeka konke phansi, wabelwa abantu bonke ngokulingana. Kakhulu niyazi ukuthi babela abanganani, abanganani lutho ukuthi bafane nalabo.
Amen.
They were having lands, they were having fields, but they sold them. They were having houses. Can I sell my house? Can I sell my mansion? and give the, all the money to the poor, to Jesus, and said, I'm going to stay in the house of the Lord and work for Jesus. It's difficult, but may God help us. Amen. Because we want to go to the same heaven. Niyazi bazalwane, izinto zalapha emhlabeni. It's just a waste of time. Kuthiwa kuyomsiza ngani umuntu ukufuya umhlaba wonke alahlekelwe umphefumulo wakhe. What shall profit a man to gain the whole world but loses his soul? Lokhu kwana emhlabeni kokusibambezela kwesikhashana ngoba siyahamba sikushiye. Siyahamba nezindlu, nezimali, nezimoto. Eboxini uzoba uyi-one ungekho lutho. Basale benzani? Maybe nemali yakhona uzange uyidle. Bewuyibeke ebank ukuthi ngifuna ukuthi igcwale. Uhlupheka, uhlupheka nabantwana banganayo imali yokuya esikolweni, banganayo ukudla, kanti imali igcwele ebank umuntu ufuna ukuthi ibe million. Abe a millionaire. For what? The day usathi manje ifika imillion, uyashona. Bayasala bayenzani? Bayalwela. Abantwana baze babulalane, babulalelele imali kababa. Leyi ubaba akazange ayinjoye umasaphila. Ah, may God help us. Asihlakaniphe lokubalulakula emhlabeni kuyaphela. Ungathi uNkulunkulu angasisiza sibone ukuthi kwesikhashana. UNkulunkulu uma angasinikeza izinto. When gave, God give us possessions or material things, He wants us to help others. Not to enjoy alone. Because if you enjoy alone, you will take and give to someone who will share with the needy. So may God help us. Nenkonzo, nenkonzo manje. Uma ingaba nezinto. Singayekeli abantu abahluphekile balala nendlala ngoba imali igcwele ebank, imali ekuyishumi. For what? Ngoba yokunakekela umsebenzi nokunakekela abantu abahluphekayo. May God help us. Akusizi ukuthi sibe nemali izosala kuze abanye abantu abazali bayazi nokuthi kusetshenziwe kanjani, bahlaphaze benze izinto zabo. So uma sisaphila sinikezwe isikhathi asisebenzeni singisebenzele uNkulunkulu the way azojabula ngakhona. Nabaseleyo bazothini? Ha, laba bantu basebenzile. Bekungeke umuntu ohluphekayo. Ha, thula sikhonza sonke. Umuntu uyahlupheka aseye kumatshonisa bamthathele ke enkonzweni kungayaziwa. Niyazi kunye zinkonzo kunani? A fund for the needy. Awufaki igama lakho. Ufake envelope uthi for the need. Bazi ukuthi leya mali bazoyenza yini, bazoyisebenzisela abantu abahluphekileyo. So kangakanani kithi. So may God help us. Let's just take care of the needy. Laphaya kuMathewu kuthiwa izinto zonke zalapha emhlabeni. A material thing. Kungcono ukuzibuthela, singazibutheli izinto zalapha emhlabeni eziphelayo. Angithi, imfuyo yethu masizibekele kuphi? Masibhenke ezulwini. Lapho kunganani, kungena izinto ezizodla. Lapho emhlabeni ziyadla, bayatshontsha ama-thieves. So may God help us. Uma singaba nalo mcabango singabi nendaba ne-material things. Nani uNkulunkulu angisize sizobona abantu abaningi bazophenduka. Do you know ukuthi kwenzakalani uma abapostola by one bashumayela? Siyazi ukuthi uPeter washumayela wasindiswa abantu bayingaki? 3,000. One time they were baptized. They were converted. Baphenduka ezonweni zabo. Ba-Ethio. Kuneyinye ivesi futhi sithola khona lapha esifundweni sethu asizange kaningi ayikhulunywa but kuthiwa ngesesikhathi uma bashumayela abapostola kwa many were added kwakhulunywa ngabantu be 5,000 abaphendukileyo ngenxa yani ye-oneness. Uma singaba ne-sanctification singaba nokungcwele sibe ne-oneness akungcwala and ngeke kugcwala ukuthi abantu bagcwala bayenza izulu. No, bagcwala bamsebenzele uNkulunkulu, bamsaba. Uma singamsaba uNkulunkulu ngeke siyenze into right. Let's continue with our lesson. Isigaba sethu sesibili. It says the hypocrisy of Ananias and Sapphira. Your hypocrisy. Bakhona abantu uzobabona ame phambi kwabantu agqoke kahle, akhuluma kahle nge voice eli soft, wathi umuntu oyingcwele. Hlangana naye kungekho abazalwane or umasekhaya kungekho umfundisi uzomkhohlwa ukuthi umuye. So singabe abantu abanjalo. Ngisho nami angisho abanye nami ngingabe umuntu onjalo. Lokhu kubonakala ngaphandle makube ukuthi nangaphakathi kunjalo. So let's hear about it's very terrible, the lies of Ananias and Sapphira. Ananias and Sapphira sold a possession and kept back part of the price. Let's read Acts 5 from verse 1.
Acts chapter 5, verse 1. But a certain man named Ananias,
verse 1 and 2 only,
mm-hmm. with Sapphira his wife, sold a possession too, and kept back part of the price, his wife also being privy to it, and brought a certain part and laid it at the apostles' feet.
They brought a certain part. Baleta okuncane. Bathengise. Kukhona umuntu beyabafostela ukuthi bathengise. La uma sizwe isifundo le akukho umuntu beyafostela. Bonke kwaphuma ezinhlizweni zabo ukuthi bayenzeni? Bathengise, balethe, bahlanganise. So uma ungafostela uzibulalisilani ngento le ungafostelanga ukuthi uyenze. Kusho ukuthi bebafuna ukwenzani? Ukubonwa ngabantu. They wanted to be praised by people. Oh, unkulunkulu makasize singabe abantu abafuna ukupraiswa ngabantu. Ngoba umuntu akanalo izulu. Uyafa yena asala kuphenduka. So may God help us. So let's hear ukuthi uma afika laphaya uAnania athi imali iyo yona le uPeter. Ha, Peter had, he was a leader, he had the Holy Spirit. Kufuneka ama leader ene anomuya moya oyingcwele. Uma umzalwane aza nezinto zakhe zingekho right zokugcilisa ibandla, zokudiliza ibandla, abe nomoya oyingcwele okukhona ukubona ukuthi wena hamba uyofela ukude nendaba zakho. Angifuni ibandla likaNkulunkulu liyenzeni liwe or lihlukane ngaphansi kwami. So may God help us. Asizweni asifunde insizwe ukuthi uPeter wathini after bakhulume ama uAnanias akhulume amanga.
Verse 3. But Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled thine heart to lie to the Holy Ghost and to keep back part of the price of the land? Verse 4. Once it remained, was it not thine own? And after it was sold, was it not thine own power? Was it not in thy own power? Why hast thou conceived this thing in thy heart? Thou hast not lied unto men, but unto God. Verse 5. And Ananias, hearing these words, fell down.
Oh, okay. Siyabonga. In Zulu, verse 2 to 4.
Verse 2 to 4.
Mm-hmm.
What was then in your mind? It was not God. But you would come among a God hates lies. Yeah.
greedy. God is watching. Nyazi u Petro bene moya ngulu. Akazangathi umcambele amanga. Uthi waye uSatan angene enhlizweni yami. Wacambela umoya ongcwele amanga. Ngoba umoya ongcwele uyabona, ngithi bekugcwele uyabona. Ngeke usifihle usifihlele umoya ongcwele. Ngeke usifihle usifihlele uNkulunkulu. Ah, wathini? Noma nikeze isikhathi wathini? Iyo leyo imali. Oh, kwenzekala. A judgment. Yenzekala masinyane. Wavela wenza ini? Wawa. Wawa wenza ini? Wafa. Same time. Uma afa acambe amanga, uyongena ezulwini. Ukuzihlupha kwake isikhathi lesiya sonke, anabapostola yenze konke. Kusabalwa. Unkulunkulu angasisiza. Asiqaleni kahle, sicide kahle. Wonke sikuyenza asikwenzi umuntu siyaziyenzela thina. Wafa. Kabuhlungu. Ane umthetho walesi sikhathi, bima ungachitha isikhathi. Uma ushona bavele benzeni, bakuthwale baye kungcwaba. Ungathi beba bekungafuniki nemvumo yokuthi bathele nonkosikazi ukuthi ushonile. Bavele bakuthathe bayenzani? Bayokulahla bazoyenza bayokukhombisa baby incwaba ukuthi ushonile simncwabe lapha. Niyabona ukuthi it was tough. But now ha umama uyalandela after isikhathi angazi ukuthi bathi after 30 minutes or isikhathi singakanani uyalandela after isikhathi abazani bonke isikhathi esinye mara baplanile bonke ukuthi siyosho ukuthi imali ile. Oh, it was so sad. Niyabona indaba le, the thing of a husband and a wife. Sometimes it's very dangerous. Into entry in our marriage. But when coming to the truth, to stand, when coming to standing for the truth, you must stand alone. Uzi we are one, nothing is any one. So, when it is siyayengana, singayengkonzweni umuntu kuyabanda. Siyayengana. Kufuneka izimali enkonzweni, ha singakhiphi umsakukho osibonayo. Kufuneka izimali emsebenzini kaNkulunkulu, ha uyabona nawe mama izinto ziningi, indlu, ibond, abantwana besikolo, yini ifuel, everything. So uma singakhipha sisenkonzweni, ha sizoshotheka. Ha ingwenya zizwane kanjani kanti uNkulunkulu ubhekile. Kani the more nikhululeka nonke nikhuthazana kwenze ukuhle, the more uNkulunkulu anibhlesa nonke.
Amen.
So mikwedel pasi. Na baba yengana sizweni, at least street sizwe ukuthi kwenzakalani.
Verse 5. Verse 6. And the young man arose, wound him up, and carried him out and buried him. Verse 7. And it was about the space.
Can you read first? Then?
And yes. It was about the space of 3 hours.
Oh, 3 hours.
After.
Okay.
When his wife, not knowing what was done, came in. Verse 8. And Peter answered unto her, tell me whether he sold the land for so much. And she said, yea, for so much. 9. Then Peter said unto her, how is he that ye have agreed together to tempt the Spirit of the Lord? Behold, the feet of them which have buried thy husband are at the door, and shall carry thee out. 10. Then fell she down straightway at his feet, and yielded up the ghost, and the young man came in and found her dead, and carrying her forth buried her by her husband. Verse 11. And the great fear came upon all the church, and upon as many as had visitors.
The church were horrified. The judgment lay even fast, even swift. After the bush, Ugumwaba, his daughter, Umama, who is Okurumamanga, until Nayuwera Pansi, by Umwaba. There's no secret. I go in fit about the sinai and see two sitting on the board. Let's read Ecclesiastes 12, verse 14.
For God shall bring every work into judgment.
For God shall bring every work into judgment. Okay?
With every secret thing.
With every secret thing. If the fishers all get your basubara.
Whether it be good or whether it be evil.
Whether it be good or whether it be evil. Bon yoko vena sobala. So kulukulu maga sizo. Umakuyo kufike sikati so kutu kufele sobala. Sibe sienzeni. Silungi. So lapa. Sige zaba wana awanyi. Ukora no tatani no abira. Bayenzaini. Bakulu mama. Wachoncha. Wawenzaini. Umshaba. Bakulu mama. Umshaba wawenzaini. Wafulega. Sinta, wafulega, ba kanakatela panzi bonke, nemizi yabo. Imizi yabo, abantwana babo, bebayenze something, nemfuyo yabo. Bakulalisa abantwana babo na mafebelizi wabo. Ngesikhathi siyabulalisa mafebelizi wethu. Nangu Ananiya no Safira bafile. Uma bebana abantwana, abantwana basala kanjani? Ende abasekho emuseni, abazali bafe bangekho emuseni. Nibona ngathi abantwana kumuso ukuthi abantwana basale balandele. So may God help us. Angulukulu makasize kuphungule indaba. Ungathi uNkulunkulu angakubeka enhliziyweni sibone ukuthi konke sikwenzeka uNkulunkulu ubhekile asenzele omunye umuntu siyazenzeka. I-judgment izokuzela kuyi one. And kuzoba kungena sikhathi esizokuphendula. So uNkulunkulu makasize ngesikhathi samanje uNkulunkulu uyasinikeza yini isikhathi eside sikwenza sokuphendula. Ngoba sometimes umuntu akafima sinyana. Umuntu wenza ubufebi, ayenza asule imlomo, ayenza izinto zakhe akubude abazalwane bangamboni. Kakhulu ngasilesi sikhathi sama-lockdown, asiyazi ukuthi abantu bayenzani ezindlini nalapho baba khona. Ngoba the more ungathula isikhathi sokukhonza, the more uSathane azinikeza amandla empilweni yakho. Ngaphandle uma ungahlala kuphi emthandazweni. UNkulunkulu ufunda iBhayibheli, uNkulunkulu uyakuqinisa. Noma kuyiwani, ulalele ama-livestream, ufunde, ulalele, uhlale uzikhipha busy ngezinto zikaNkulunkulu. Uyaqina noma ungekho. But uNkulunkulu makasize, ngoba God is watching ukuthi siyenzani silapho sikhona. Umama angabangekho, abantwana abangekho, ubaba abangekho, lapho sikhona emsebenzini everywhere, God is watching. Uzosirewarda. So kungcono singazifihli, siyazi ukuthi ukhona usibonayo. So may God help us. Okay, ushonile kubuhlungu. Uma isifundo sethu siyaphambili, sizwanga the signs that follows believers. Bathukile, but akuzange kusitope ukuthi uNkulunkulu anze imihlolo. Kulaba basaleyo bayenzeni? Bahambelele. Let's read.
And by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people. Mm-hmm. And they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch. Mm-hmm. Verse 18. And of the rest durst no man join himself to them, but the people magnified them. Verse 14. And believers were the more added to the Lord, multitude both of men and women. Insomuch that they brought forth the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. 16. There came also a multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folks and them which were vexed with unclean spirits, and they were healed everywhere.
Amen. Siyabonga. Ukushona niyabona ukuthi abantu bayayengana bahambe. Lokho akusitopi umsebenzi kaNkulunkulu ukuthi umsale uhambe. Abantu bayayengana bayabangane abanye bashone umsebenzi kaNkulunkulu usale uhambe. Labaya uthole ukuthi abanye ngesinye isikhathi basala baphendula. So singayengwa umuntu. umuntu makazimele ayiwani ungafuna ukuzwa ukuthi umunye uyenzani omunye uyenzani mikorel basa uthiwe those signs were approval that God was in their midst. It was an approval that the Holy Spirit was in their midst. So ama signs akhona because they were in one accord, many were saved. Waedo ama Christe amaningi ngathi uNkulunkulu angasenzela namuntu noma sina ba 2-3 saba in one accord uNkulunkulu wenze ipro.
Amen.
Yosindiswa abaningi laba singabayazi sizohlangana nabo kuphi izulwini. Singabona ngathi le into incane but God is watching.
Amen.
He is busy preparing an invisible church. Le sizohlangana nayo phambili. So uNkulunkulu makasize.
Amen.
Many were saved, many were added, the sick were healed.
Amen.
The sick were healed. Abagulayo bayenzani? Baphila. Angithi sizike sazwa lapha ukuphiliswa isishosha lesa. Peter and Martin, silver and gold have I none. Bebeba nakho kwabo, but such as I have, give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Nibona ungathi ngabe bakunikeze imali uma bebanayo. Nokuphiliswa into enkulu yini ukuphiliswa akhona ukuzihambela eyomphonzo uNkulunkulu ayekile ukuhlala ayenzani acela so uNkulunkulu makasize uma singa if we win souls siyenze umsebenzi omkhulu noma bangathola ini next esandleni uma singenani but uma singakho basibanikeze. The unclean spirit were healed. Imimoya emibi yaxoshwa. Yabacamba ngamagama ibayazi. Ah, sibuNkulunkulu. Namhlanje iyasuka iyabaleka imimoya emibi ifuna unity. SibuNkulunkulu makasize.
Amen.
Let's read this yaqeda Mark 16 verse 17 and 18. Or sesifundi Mark 16 verse 17 and 18.
Mark chapter 16, verse 17.
Mm.
And this sign shall follow them that believe.
Mm-hmm.
In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 18. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover.
Mm.
It was a promise. Le promise igiti. Let us claim it.
Amen.
By living a holy life, by praying, by staying in one accord. So in conclusion, we must take this conversation and plant it. Umoya kaNkulunkulu usisiza. Masibhekene indaba kaAnania noSaphira. Uma siqeda. Siyazi ukuthi God has no pleasure in the death of a sinner. God has no pleasure in the death of a sinner. Let's read Ezekiel 33, verse 11. In Zulu and in English. God has no pleasure in the death of a sinner.
Isobona ukuthi kuphela kami usho iNkosi uJehova angithokozele angithokoze ekufeni komubi kodwa ekubuyeni komubi endleleni yakhe aphile tendukani niphenduke ezindleleni zenu ezimbi ngokuba niyakufanani indlu ka-Israyeli.
In English.
Ezekiel 33, verse 11. Say unto them, as I live, saith the Lord God, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live. Turn ye from your evil ways, for why will ye die, O house of Israel?
Why will ye die? Siphila esikhathini esinzima lapho kufiwa khona. Kuthiwa uNkulunkulu akajabuleli ukufa, has no pleasure in the death of a sinner. But precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints.
Amen.
Akajabulela ukufa kwesono, but uma kufa umuntu oyingcwele, uJehova uyajabula.
Amen.
Sina singakhala sithi yo uNkulunkulu silahlile, kanti uNkulunkulu nezimpilo zenza ziyajabula. So it's up to us ukuthi siyaphenduka na before leli langa elifikele oAnania neSapphira elifika. UNkulunkulu makasize. UNkulunkulu uyasincenga ukuthi senzeni siphenduke before leli langa lifika. May God help us. Let our death be precious in the sight of the Lord. Noma abantu bakhala bathi mbe uNkulunkulu umfanishile uhambile, uNkulunkulu hayi ayazi ukuthi ujabulile ngokufa kwakhe. May God help us.
Amen.
Siyabonga kakhulu. That's the end of our lesson. Fundisi, there's nothing siyabonga. We thank God. May God help us. Let this lesson be a wake-up call to me and all of us.
Amen.
We thank God. Hallelujah. Sizo is a family in the number 166, the Lord of Evangeli, from verse 4. Lingi Shuma, Jesu, Jesu.
Lingi Shuma.
Lingi Shuma, Jesu, Jesu.
Lingi Shuma.
Lingi Shuma, Jesu, Jesu.
Amen.
Amen.